So, I mean, I think, you know, clearly we've heard a lot about hacking in the space. And, you know, when I start to kind of evaluate that from my perspective, you know, you're not necessarily seeing a lot of hacking from an enterprise level at the private key and wallet infrastructure level, right? It does occur, you know, you need to safeguard those, that critical infrastructure. But generally people are well aware of that. And if they're working with, you know, outside vendors, you know, they've done a pretty good job creating a perimeter around the concept of the private key. Where we're really seeing a lot of compromise occur is within the ancillary components that in effect govern or have governance over, you know, the key signing process. So if you think about user authentication, if you think about policy governance and basically where that sits, if you see, think about, you know, your whitelisted address databases and where those sit, those are where we're actually seeing a lot of malicious actions occur. You know, someone compromising the system with phishing, basically gaining access within into your internal tools and basically changing databases that are non-secured to then execute malicious actions, right? And that's where you're really seeing, I think, the ingenuity around, you know, some of these malicious actors. And from our perspective, that's where we also take time to really bring in our knowledge from a cybersecurity perspective to harden all those different components, therefore mitigating a lot of the risks that we're really seeing in the space. And so, you know, obviously it's a risk, but we look to, you know, really mitigate those things at Fireblocks by really thinking about what are all the different governance components, the different user authentication, you know, components that then go into allowing for, you know, a transaction to occur. And then how do we really strengthen those utilizing hardware?